I would just start, because probably the people who have come late, they've already seen the introduction. Hello.
Hello.
So this talk is going to be about the art of estimation, why they sometimes go wrong, and how to estimate better. I wish that I had the answer. I, of course, don't have a concrete answer here, but I have definitely like a couple of tricks and tips on how we could do this better. Because this is definitely a process that we always struggle with, and we have been going, you know, we've been going through a lot of phases until we have actually gone through the where we think now that we have a really good estimation process. So I wanted to share that with you. Again, for those who haven't seen the other, you know, Baddy and Christoph. Again, sorry, my husband there is sitting in that. So he is this year. So I have a bachelor in computer science from the Reykjavik University and then a master in engineering management from TUV. I've been working with Drupal since 2007. And these two kids there, they are my new project since a couple of years, or our new project. So about OneX Internet, we are a Drupal agency here in Frankfurt. We also have a couple of people both in Barcelona and Reykjavik. We are around 18 people, and we, for example, organize and are in charge of the Drupal Iceland, which Ruben came to. Nobody else, Crystal, of course. What?
It was cool,
the coolest camp ever. Otherwise, we do Drupal projects in, of course, we have old projects in Drupal 6 still running, like very old, but we do not do anything with them, they're mostly running. We have a lot of Drupal 7 projects, and now since 1.5 years, we have Drupal 8 projects. So I think the first Drupal 8 project went live around about 1 year ago. So we've been doing, you know, going live with very many since around 1 year. Otherwise, we developed the eGov together with two other agencies, and then we do a lot of Drupal commerce. And Christoph, I'm going to do a little bit of advertisement. Christoph is going to do a talk about Drupal commerce at 11:45.
Yes.
And how we did the first commerce to Drupal 8. And picture of our team. Ruben is somewhere there, either back or, you know. So, now we're gonna play a game because it's so early in the morning and everybody is so excited. Let's estimate. Okay. So let's imagine we have a really like content-rich page. You know, let's think about the au pair world that you guys are working with. You know, it's a page that has like endless of content types, you know, of content and all this stuff. So let's estimate. So, is it going to take 5 days?
What?
No, to estimate how long it's going to take to do it.
Build the website.
You know, let's just try to estimate how long it's going to take, because, you know, client comes in and he says, can you, how long does it take to rebuild this, or whatever it is. You know, and this is actually what we then stand, and we're like...
You're missing the zeros, that's
why they're not here. Yes. Anyways. Okay.
It's for 2 days.
Yes. So for the OPR world, it's probably going to be like, 50, 100, or 2,000. We don't know. Because it is just impossible. Right? That we all know. So, nothing new. It's just impossible. And this little part, you know, maybe you've seen it before, we're really, because it's been difficult, so I need a budget estimate for my project, but I don't have a scope or design for it yet. Okay, let's do an estimate. It's 3,583,729. But you don't know anything about my project. Yep, exactly. So, this is just guessing, you know, and this is nothing more than that, and probably You all know this, and you have been in this situation. So, for estimating, you need relevant information, okay? And then I would like to ask you, in your companies that you're working for, have you ever heard these comments? Have you ever heard this one? our clients are impossible, they are always changing their minds. Has anybody heard this? The next one is, oh, our developers, they are so bad at estimating. And the next one, that this is also very typical from developers, that the product was just sold way too cheap. So if you have, and I suppose that most of you have heard some of these comments, if you have heard them, then there is something wrong in your internal process. And that is a little bit what we're going to go through now, is that how can we change this so this does not happen, so we do not have to go through these frustrations that then take place during the project. So let's look at the process. These are the stakeholders in the estimation phase. So we have the client who really knows what he needs. He does. He just doesn't know how he's going to get there, but he has a really good idea about, you know, why he needs a new website or why he needs a new system. Then you have the product manager, and then you have a developer, at least one. So in our company, we have a couple of developers that we really like to, you know, ask for, you know, that we get into the process, and we're going to go through the process. So this is like the stakeholders that have to be involved in the estimation process. Like, we do not want to skip the developer, and we definitely, it's not possible to skip the client. And so now let's go through a real example of a typical client request, and this is a real example from our products. So a client comes in, it's the Icelandic Institute of National History. So what they have all species that exist in Iceland. So basically we have imported all of the, you know, you have animals, like these little animals, like insects, you have birds, we have plants, you know, we have everything that is in the so-called biota. And they have, like, you know, organized all this in, and it's a really beautiful website, which, you know, has a lot of details, like a big menu tree, a lot of stuff about this. And their request was, we want to add a search to our website. And this is not a, you know, it's already our client, so we know that they're just, like, nice, they have a good understanding, but they basically know what they need. They want to have an awesome search, and this is basically what they say to us. We want to have a search, can we have an estimation for it? So there are a couple of ways how to go at it. We could offer them the simple search. This would be a typical simple search that comes out of the box. You search for a butterfly, and you get results. So this is basically by turning on search and maybe do a little bit of configuration and you have this. So, do they need this? We don't know, you know. Or we can also go for the advanced search, which is the complete opposite. And sorry, this is in Icelandic, I didn't translate this, but on the left side, it's really bad quality, right? It doesn't matter. On the left side, we have like a lot of facets and, you know, the tree that goes completely down, you can choose and select. Here you can see, you know, we did it the Google way, where you have, you search for a butterfly, you first get all, but then you can also go into groups. You can group by either, or you can have results based on news, results based on what is an animal. So you can really, like, the customer can really look at, and he can get the results what he needs.
What does it say? All news?
All news, biota, basic page, staff, and documents and files. So if you search for a butterfly, you know, now I'm already now deep into the biota, which is the animal section. But in the beginning, you can get the different types. So this is just a really advanced search that.
So the filter is active?
Yeah, the filter active, yeah. So, the client doesn't know what he wants. Let's do it agile! Yeah, everybody really happy. So the client doesn't know if he needs the other one or the other one. You know, he really doesn't. So we say this to them. Let's do it agile. You know. But the client disagrees with us because he says, yeah, but I need a budget and I need a scope. I need to know what I will get for this budget because then I'm gonna go and I'm gonna talk to my people and we have already agreed on having so much budget and there needs to be a budget and we also need to know what we're gonna get for this budget. So all our beautiful ideas of doing it completely agile and just on the fly, estimate and do like planning pokers like crazy here and all that, they just completely fall apart because it's not possible, you know. If it is possible, we try to do it, but I don't know, maybe I can say 90%, 95%. It is just not possible. The client wants to have a budget and a scope. So then we of course have to work and try to estimate. So how can we now find out if he wants the simple search or the advanced search? So we start there. We start by having the client and the project manager. And now the real work starts. You know, you have to ask these questions. And of course, very many other questions. But these are a couple of, you know, what problem is the client trying to solve? Does he just want to have a search so you can find information? Or is he really trying to help the researchers in Iceland to find the correct species based on, you know, if somebody finds an animal or an insect there and he goes and he thinks there is a kakalake or a cockroach, you know, and he goes on here and he checks the pictures, you know, what is he trying to solve? To whom is he speaking to? Then you have to ask all these questions. You have to sit, you know, you have to be with the client and you have a lot of discussions about this. Then, at the same time, you cannot just sit with the client and just tell him about all these awesome ideas if he doesn't have a budget. So that will not help. So try to figure out what his budget is. Try to like get a feeling of if he's willing to, you know, spend 5,000 euros on it or if he's willing to spend 20,000 euros on it. Just try to like, because otherwise it will not help to tell him about all these awesome ideas about the advanced search. Look at other websites, you know, because client often just like, you know, I'm not saying that they say, just do it like Google, but sometimes they don't do. You know, we have like Google finds it all. It's like, yeah. But try to look at all the websites and make it realistic and what is possible and what not. Make wireframes. So now I'm not talking about doing detailed wireframes about everything, but what we definitely do, we start to draw it up just on a board. You know, it's not that official because we haven't got the product yet, so we're not gonna sit and wireframe everything, but like draw it up so they get the idea. And this process, we iterate and iterate and iterate. In a project like this, where you're gonna build a search, you as a project manager or key account or who the person who is actually sales, doing sales. And by the way, I am of course talking, we are an 18 people company, so we don't have sales departments that are doing, you know, it's just how we handle this here with us. Very often I have to get in a technical person. So I will involve a developer here because it's maybe not possible for me to think about, is this facet possible to do or how is it all structured? So I will, you know, take a developer here in meetings to get help. So now we have the requirements and this has taken a while, you know, this takes time. So we have the requirements. And we have a concept, like, we have a, not a detailed technical concept, but we have a concept that developers can then really estimate from.
Hi.
So, then basically the project, like, we swift it, and we swift it over to the product management, or the product manager and the developer. So here, the client is not involved anymore because we 100% know that the client wants the advanced search. So we have written it all down. And even we have involved a technical person. So now we have the developer and the product manager. And now we, of course, we start to explain this to the developers. What are the requirements? we let them here completely challenge the concept. So, of course, we feel very confident of what we have told the client is going to work out, but still, we, to double check, we allow the developers to challenge what we have decided to do. And then we start to discuss technical challenges, so we know, like, where are we going to have problems, do we need to build some prototypes? Guys, if you need questions or anything like that, just please ask, and you're going to get also the slides for those who are, like, really written ready. You also will get the slides. And then, of course, like, if you have really big tasks, we get an opinion from a second developer, and then we do, like, this... For example, we let Crystal here take the first set of estimation, and then we basically delete what he said. Not delete, but we copy the sheet, and then we go through another, you know, with this, with another developer just to get the feeling, and that depends on the size. Then what has been really helpful for us is to, in the estimation phase, to test and prototype key functionality. This can take a while, but this is definitely worth it before you start selling this to the client. And here you have to then be careful that you spend the time and the, you know, that you can, and you have to be really confident that you just don't do this and then we're not going to get it. But if we talk about the facets in the search, you know, sometimes there are like some facets that we think that are awesome, but nobody of us has done it before. So then it is definitely worth it to just let the developer have 1 or 2 days of testing if this is possible to do. So it will not come, you know, backfiring later on in the process. So now we have the requirements, of course, and all that, and now we actually have an estimation. What then happens is that the developer is then just out, you know, or the developers. We don't need them anymore. We have a client that goes to the product manager that goes to the client. Of course, the product manager takes this estimation from the developer, and we add a lot of buffer on it. What was one of the questions before, right? About our developers are bad at estimating. You know, they learn and they get better in the estimation. But we definitely have to add some buffer to it. We have to add product management, testing, and the risks in the project. You know, is this something that we have done before or not? Then what is very important is to define what is included and what to define, how to define, like, what is not included. And this is the most important when you have to deliver a budget and a scope. And for those who came in later on, it's not applying to the HL projects, which we then don't have to do this. But in these cases, it's very helpful to try to go through everything that you try to imagine everything that could come. And I'm gonna make you an example of one thing that happened recently is that we were supposed to build an iframe onto a page. And the page was like a slider page. So it was not a long one pager, it was just a typical slider that should then function on all devices. And there was an iframe on it. And this iframe is just like, hey, oh, you put in an iframe. Done. And yeah.
Oh, sorry.
That's gonna turn this off. And what you do then is that when you estimate the iframe, you just maybe estimate it to half a day, you know, test on all devices, everything works. It is then important that you also say that this is what you actually are estimating, because what you're definitely not estimating is that you are not thinking about that the iframe can actually change and become bigger when you start clicking inside of the iframe and all this stuff. So, you know, because in this case, the iframe was that you go on it and you click it and then it starts to, like, grow. And you start to get a lot of problems with the iframe. And it is really good that you just say to the client in the beginning that you had estimate half a day for the iframe. Because when then comes problems that you're not aware of later on, then you can always go back to this and say, like, hey, yeah, but we didn't expect this, or this was not, you know, no. So write this all down and write more than, you know, just try to write everything down that you can. Discuss this with the client, of course, because you have to see if the client also agrees with this and make sure that the expectations of the client match your concept. So the work that you've been doing up till now, just 100% make sure that everything is exactly what the client expects. And if you go through this process, you are most likely, and this is our experience, you are going to have a successful project, which is all what we want in the end. We want to have a happy client, and we want to have happy programmers and happy business owners. So therefore, you should consider and not skip any of these steps. But this maybe would then come up, like, yes, I said this before, this is very, very expensive process. You know, are we going to do this every time and just spend all this time and then maybe not get the project? So I made this table here, and I haven't made it nice yet because I don't know how to make it nicer. But I tried to split the project up, like, what type of a project are we estimating? Into categories. And then, like, the risk involved and how accurate we can be and what type of processes are. So, like I said in the beginning, like, agile, you know, it's not maybe true that you have no information, you have a lot of information, but you do it on the fly. You know, there's non-risk involved. The accuracy is really high because you only do what you want to do. And so there's this 100% trust. And of course there is a budget with the client, but there is this works really well. You know, this is just the best what we can do. But we also have the other three types, which is number one, very limited information. This is very typical when the client comes and he is basically shortlisting. So he says, like, hey, I'm going to have an offer from 5 companies. So I really would like to get, like, an estimation from you. How much is it going to cost? You have very limited information about the project. About, you know, you basically have what we said before. I want to add a search to my page. And this is, how I approach this is like dating. You know, I haven't been dating for a while though. But I assume how it is, you know, you spend time with the client and you just, like, you try to get a feeling about, like, what he needs and what he wants out of me, and, you know, it's like, and then you just, you know, you say everything really nice just to get on the shortlist. You know, you basically lie to getting more information. But you have to, in this phase, you have to somehow get, you know, if you want to do the product, of course, this is all assuming that you want to do the product. Yeah. Very often you just have to say, in this case, I'm not interested. But you have to guess, you have to try to, you know, get feeling of the budget, and you have to, like, just say something so you get into the next phase. Then we have the situation of good information, and this is typically like the public tenders, the Ausschreibungen, like they say it in German. We had a big Ausschreibung that we participated in the other day, and it was very detailed. It was 100 pages of information of what the client wanted. Well, you know, it was only based on price. So the one with the lowest price, he wins the thing. So you have to just, you know, you have to guess, you know, a lot of stuff. But in this one, it really said that the search, because we were talking about the search from the start, the search should be, you know, like Google. All words should be put in, and we should use an Icelandic library of, like, to see what kind of a variation of this word exists. So also it finds information like that. And it should be really nice and search all files and documents. Like, this was the description in the public offering, in the public offering of a government page. And this is, you know, this is ridiculous. You know, you can only, you have to compete on a price. So you have a medium risk, definitely. You know, it's well defined, but you have risk there because there are so much that you don't know. You can also not be accurate, and so therefore, you know, but still you have to put out the estimation and the offer. Then, of course, the detailed information we love, and we try to convince all of our clients to do a discovery with us, paid discovery, so we get to detailed information. Because when we do a paid discovery with a client or workshop concept, we of course tell her, hey, sit down with us, then we can get the, you know, then we get all the questions that we had before, we get them all answered in the concept phase, in the discovery phase. We have it really detailed, what's going to be in the backlog, we have it, and we can really do an accurate estimate, and we have a very low risk there. So this is a definitely, like, of course the two here are best case scenarios, but reality for everybody who's working in an agency here, reality is that we very often have to deal with the other two, and then yeah, we have to see how we're going to do this. So the conclusions from what I've been saying is that number one is this is a process. Delivering estimation, it takes time. We have to accept it as business owners. We have to accept it as product managers that we have to spend time on this process if we are going to end up with a good product. And we have to also do the risk analysis of, like I showed you before, you know, what is the risk versus the potential of the offer that you're making to decide, am I going to do prototypes to test key functionality? So that is just the first step. And the product manager needs to be in control. And this is just in order to not to get these three questions that we had in the beginning, you know, why are developers so bad at estimating, or why did we sell the product so cheap, and all that. The product manager is responsible. So in our case, we don't have any sales department, like I said before. It's the product manager or the key account manager. He is just responsible. Together with the business owners, of course, but he is responsible that then during the project, that the client is going to be happy and going to get what he expects, and the developers are going to be happy, because that's the most important, that the developers are happy in the process and that they feel good and do not have any frustration. So that's then just the final remarks, what I have learned, and this is probably what I have just, my experience since now 6 or 7 years of just being in sales, selling and product management. Follow this, be open, be honest, and be confident. Just talk about the problems with the client. Tell the client that, hey, sorry, we haven't done this before. We think that we know how we can do this. We're gonna do a little prototype. We cannot have done everything before, even though the client sometimes expects it, that you are the experts. You must have done a search like that before. It's like, no, I've never had the Natural Institute of History or whatever to come, or science to, you know, I've never done anything like that. Plus, you, of course, have to think about how is the client, you know, you have to get the feeling of how difficult will this all be, and, you know, you have to just be open, be confident, and be honest. That's my, towards the client, and towards your team. So, yeah, that was it. For those who haven't been to the other sessions, check out Drupal Iceland. Follow us on Twitter, because we are going to be doing another camp, probably in 2019. During midnight, we are going to have a session about something like that. No, a keynote. So please start following us if you're interested in coming in 2 years. Yeah. So any questions? Yes. Do it.
So when it comes to the discovery, the client says,
hey, I want search.
How important are user stories for you for getting into the discovery? Like, okay, as a visitor of the website, I want you to do this, or as an expert, I want you to do that.
So very, very important. This we tried to do in the here. Just gonna go back to that one. We try to do as many user stories in this phase as we can. At least to the level that we need to, yeah. To write them down, you know, because this is the information that we will get from this phase. When we then go, like, this is only about the estimation, so this is not has nothing to do with what then happens when, because then comes a process of we then send this to the client, and the client needs to get the budget from the top and all that, and the client will then say yes to it 5 weeks later, and we will start the project 8 weeks later, and then of course like it's 8 week process from this phase to then really doing of it. And then all this needs to be iterated again, and that's another process that is also very defined with us, how we then start to do the task breakdown, how we prioritize them. Like we have already prioritized the backlog here with the client, but then we just do it again, you know, because we have also very often gotten a little bit more information after we get the okay. So user story is very important to start writing them down as soon as possible.
If you allow a second question, how accurate was the estimation in this case?
In the search, 100%.
So you were in time and budget as
everything, and this is what we of course in the like in this example, we really took it all the way in the estimation phase, and we really went into details. So it came out exactly how it was. Was also a very nice client, and that has a big, yeah, that is just a big factor that we can never estimate. If there's going to be a client who says he just 100% says like, yeah, this is what I want, we have talked about it and this is what he got and he was happy. That is probably something in the risk that you can't add. How the client is then going to be in the end. But this project actually went, but we also spent very much time in the estimation.
How much?
Of hours, of 9 days.
Yeah.
This was a long process of maybe 2 months in total. It was basically a discovery that the client paid for, but which was then involved like in the estimation, because we knew that we had the client. It was probably 5, you know, in that case it's not such a big project, you know, in the total I think the search engine was around about 20 days to do the search engine, and of that probably we spent 5 days in this phase, that we then of course had to add in the buffer. But 20 man days, it definitely, like the project itself was, the project was very simple in the end then. Because it was correctly estimated. And this risk, you can only take, like you can only decide on you spending 5 man days on that, you know, if you know that you're gonna get it.
So without having this calculated, but I think like to me it sounds sensible that if you have a project like that you have 25% would be estimation phase, and then you have another 25% which is specification phase, because like often before you start implementing you also have to like specify stuff, and then the implementation itself is probably only 50% of the total time spent on the budget.
Yeah.
I think
if you're gonna do it, if you're gonna do it correctly.
Yeah. Size like this, 50% implementation. 15 cents
estimation of classification. Yeah, so before, you know, I think we started this around about 1 year ago, that we really went detailed into this process. Before that, we spent much less time on the estimation. We took like full risk, and we said like, yeah, we know how we're gonna do it. We didn't test the key functionality, and the result of the projects were much worse than just doing this really well at the beginning. And that is probably my learning, is that this is going to affect your success of your project. Even though it is sometimes difficult to do all this and then don't get the project, you know. Any more questions? Any experiences of how you are doing it that you would like to add to the process? Good, then I'm just going to have a coffee. And if you have any questions, I'm going to have this available. Please, like, this is a topic that is, in my opinion, in all Drupal cons and on all that, it's always a topic for all of us here inside there are running agencies or projects. You know, this is one of our main headaches. So I'm really willing to, like, share information about how we do it and like to learn from you guys how you guys do it so we can all become better and get happier clients and happier developers. Yeah, thank you.